Welcome back to the scripting tutorial. This is exercise 2. We are right where we left off last time. We will make a seemingly slight change. We want the NPC to first go somewhere and then play the animation. We also want to not hardwire this into his brain, but actually make him call it as a behavior which is defined in another smart object, or in this case a smart area. Our first goal is to make him move somewhere. For this we will need a tag point and place it in the level. Just place it anywhere on the ground. The NPC must be aware of this tag point in order to move to it. For this purpose there is a critical part of the whole scripting system called AI links. An AI link defines one directional relationship between two entities. So we want to create a link from the NPC to the tag point. Select the NPC, click this button, and then click the target, which is the tag point. A link can, among other things, carry a name. Let's call it destination. You may want to see the links. To do that, you either have to use the correct CVAR or you can use this predefined script toolbar. Just play with these options and it will appear. Now it's clear that the link has a start or parent entity and the finish or child entity. Now we have the destination and we also have the means to find it. However, the NPC is still not able to move there because the whole level is lacking Navmesh. First, you have to draw a navigation area. And then click the AI request full MNM rebuild. You may have noticed there was this short message about processing the Navmesh. And again, you may visualize the generated Navmesh. The NPC can move between any two points, provided they are placed within the boundaries of this blue stuff. Let's, of course, save the level. Now let's edit the NPC's brain. We don't want him to do any of this. Instead, we want him to simply call behavior. For this, we will need call behavior node. And when you inspect the node, you can see there is behavior name and target. The target is the smart area we're gonna create in a minute, and it will hold the definition of the behavior. Let's go back and place a very simple smart area in the level. Its dimensions are unimportant. A smart area would typically have a brain, a subbrain, and maybe some behaviors. We don't need a brain. We only need the behaviors, which is enabled by a smart area template. So let's create one. Let's name the template test_st_sa, and let's also rename the smart area entity the same way. And now in the smart area tab in the behavior section, we have the ability to create a new behavior. Just click the new button and let's fill in all these properties. The name of the behavior will be move to destination. Let's use it for tag name and tree name. It is best to have both of these the same. And just like in the brain creation process, we have to define an XML file. This field points to the same folder, so let's create our new XML file for this smart area. Let's use the same subfolder and give the XML file the same name as that of the smart area entity. We can leave the other options at default settings. Press OK. When you recheck the AI root folder, you can see the file was created. So let's script the behavior. The NPC will sequentially search for the tech point, then move to the tech point, and then play the animation, and then wait forever. Since we have part of the script here, I will just copy it. When you are pasting a copied tree, you can do it with Ctrl-Shift-V, which also preserves the edges. Let's connect the nodes, and let's also insert a move node and something called a graph search. Graph search is an essential tool. It allows us to make searches through the AI link network and get the desired entities. Adding child pods to nodes like sequence is very simple. You just click with holding down the Alt key or Alt and Shift. Now let's set up the graph search. We will be searching along the only link we now have. So the origin will be our own entity, in this case the NPC. Our own entity is always referred to as this.id. However, this ID is also the default value of the origin field, so we can actually leave it empty. We also have to add some conditions for the search. This is done through filters. We will use a link tag filter, which creates conditions based on link names. Link name and tag name are the same thing. So we can just copy the link name, destination, into the field tag. Now the graph search knows which link to use, but it doesn't know which entity we want to store. The NPC is the parent entity of this link, and the tag point is the child entity, so we want to store the child. For this, we will need a new variable, so let's create one. Let's give the variable name test, and let's give it a type. Common WID. Common and WID is separated by colon. Common void is one of the most used variable types. It is used to store entities and even things like instances of animations. Also in the type field, control tab serves as autocomplete function. And that's all we need. So let's use the new variable in the filter node. So, to recapitulate, we are searching from the origin, which is this ID. This ID is the entity which will execute this script. This is the NPC. And we are searching along the destination link, and we are storing the child entity in the dest variable. And that's the tag point. Now we only have to add our newly stored tag point to the move node. The success distance property of the move node is set to 0, which means that the move will succeed only when the NPC reaches the destination, and only then the script will continue and the NPC will play the animation. The behavior is now complete, so let's save it. The only thing that we are missing is calling this behavior. So let's go back to the NPC. We can delete this part as we've moved it to the behavior. To call the behavior, we need to find the smart area. And we will do it the same way we found our tag point in the behavior. So for this, we will need a new variable, area of the type common width. And we'll use a graph search. We will be searching from this ID and we will use a link tag filter. Again, we will store the child, which will be the smart area, and we will store it in the area variable. And let's say the link will be named SA for smart area. Once we can find the area, we can finally call the behavior. So the target will be the area variable, and the behavior name will be the name of the behavior we created just a few minutes ago. In order to avoid any typos, it is best to just copy the name of the behavior. You can do this in the XML file or simply by clicking the edit button. All that's now missing is the link between the NPC and the smart area. So the link should be named SA. Save the NPC brain and save the behavior. Let's jump in and hope for the best. That seemed to be fine. Let's play it again from up close. He goes to the tag point. He plays the animation. And he goes into idle. Congratulations, you have just finished the second exercise. See you next time.